Chartres Cathedral, also known as the Cathedral of Our Lady of Chartres, is a Gothic Catholic cathedral of the Latin Church located in Chartres, France, about 80 kilometers (50 miles) southwest of Paris. The current cathedral, mostly constructed between 1194 and 1220, is the last of at least five which have occupied the site since the town became a bishopric in the 4th century. It is designated a World Heritage Site by UNESCO, which calls it the high point of French Gothic art and a masterpiece. As with any medieval bishopric, Chartres Cathedral was the most important building in the town, the center of its economy, its most famous landmark and the focal point of many activities that in modern towns are provided for by specialized civic buildings. In the Middle Ages, the cathedral functioned as a kind of marketplace, with different commercial activities centered on the different portals, particularly during the regular fairs. Textiles were sold around the north transept, while meat, vegetable and fuel sellers congregated around the south porch. Money changers had their benches, or banks, near the west portals and also in the nave itself. Wine sellers plied their trade in the nave, although occasional 13th century ordinances survive which record their being temporarily banished to the crypt to minimize disturbances. Workers of various professions gathered in particular locations around the cathedral awaiting offers of work. The cathedral has been well preserved. The majority of the original stained glass windows survive intact, while the architecture has seen only minor changes since the early 13th century. The building's exterior is dominated by heavy flying buttresses which allow the architects to increase the window size significantly, while the west end is dominated by two contrasting spires, a 105-meter (349 feet) plain pyramid completed around 1160 and a 113-meter (377 feet) early 16th century flamboyant spire on top of an older tower. Equally notable are the three great facades, each adorned with hundreds of sculpted figures illustrating key theological themes and narratives. Since at least the 12th century, the cathedral has been an important destination for travelers, and remains so to the present, attracting large numbers of Christian pilgrims, many of whom come to venerate its famous relic, the Sancta Camisa, said to be the tunic worn by the Virgin Mary at Christ's birth, as well as large numbers of secular tourists who come to admire the cathedral's architecture and historical merit.
La Montagne Saint-Michel is an island commune in Normandy, France. It is located about 1 kilometer off the country's northwestern coast, at the mouth of the Couesnon River near Avranches, and is 100 hectares in size. As of 2009, the island has a population of 44. The island has held strategic fortifications since ancient times, and since the 8th century it has been the seat of the monastery from which it draws its name. The structural composition of the town exemplifies the feudal society that constructed it: on top, God, the abbey and monastery, below, the great halls, then stores and housing, and at the bottom, outside the walls, houses for fishermen and farmers. Now a rocky tidal island, the Montagne occupied dry land in prehistoric times. As sea levels rose, the erosion reshaped the coastal landscape, and several outcrops of granite emerged in the bay, having resisted the wear and tear of the ocean better than the surrounding rocks. Montagne Saint-Michel consists of loopy granite, which solidified from an underground intrusion of molten magma about 525 million years ago, during the Cambrian period, as one of the younger parts of the Mansellian granitic batholith. The Montagne has a circumference of about 960 meters and its highest point is 92 meters above sea level. The tides can vary greatly, at roughly 14 meters between high and low watermarks. Popularly nicknamed Saint Michael in Peril of the Sea by medieval pilgrims making their way across the flats, the mount can still pose dangers for visitors who avoid the causeway and attempt the hazardous walk across the sands from the neighboring coast. Polarization and occasional flooding have created salt marsh meadows that were found to be ideally suited to grazing sheep. The well-flavored meat that results from the diet of the sheep in the salt meadow makes salt meadow lamb, a local specialty that may be found on the menus of restaurants that depend on income from the many visitors to the Mount. One of France's most recognizable landmarks, visited by more than 3 million people each year, Montana Saint-Michel and its spire on the UNESCO list of World Heritage Sites. Over 60 buildings within the commune are protected in France as monuments historiques.
The Palace of Versailles is a royal chateau in Versailles in the Île-de-France region of France. It is now open as a museum and is a very popular tourist attraction. When the chateau was built, the community of Versailles was a small village dating from the 11th century. Today, however, it is a wealthy suburb of Paris, some 20 kilometers southwest of the center of the French capital. Versailles was the seat of political power in the Kingdom of France from 1682, when King Louis XIV moved the royal court from Paris, until the royal family was forced to return to the capital in October 1789, within 3 months after the beginning of the French Revolution. Versailles is therefore famous, not only as a building, but as a symbol of the system of absolute monarchy of the Ancien Régime. The palace that we recognize today was largely completed by the death of Louis XIV in 1715. The eastern-facing palace has a U-shaped layout, with the corps de logis and symmetrical advancing secondary wings terminating with the Dufour Pavilion on the south, and the Gabriel Pavilion to the north, creating an expansive cour d'honneur known as the Royal Court. Flanking the royal court are two enormous asymmetrical wings that result in a facade of 402 meters in length. Encompassing 67,000 square meters, the palace has 700 rooms, more than 2,000 windows, 1,250 fireplaces and 67 staircases. Especially under Louis XIV, the whole senior nobility were pressured to spend large amounts of time at Versailles as a form of political control. Louis XIV evolved a rigid routine of court life as a performance, much of which took place in front of large groups of people, at some points in the day including tourists. Building the chateau and maintaining the court there was phenomenally expensive, but did a good deal to establish the dominance of French style and taste in the whole of Europe, giving French luxury manufacturing advantages that long outlasted the fall of the Ancien Régime. Louis XIV's expansion of the building was begun around 1661, with Louis Laval as architect. It was not completed until about 1715, having been worked on by architects including François Dorbay, Charles Lebrun, interiors especially, Jules Hardou and Mansard and Robert Decot. André Le Nôtre began the gardens and structures in them. There were a range of satellite buildings around the grounds. While the main chateau building remains essentially intact, though without much of its contents, some of these other buildings have been destroyed.
The Palace of Fontainebleau, located southeast of the center of Paris, in the commune of Fontainebleau, is one of the largest French royal chateaux. The medieval castle and subsequent palace served as a residence for the French monarchs from Louis VII to Napoleon III. The earliest record of a fortified castle at Fontainebleau dates to 1137. It became a favorite residence and hunting lodge of the kings of France because of the abundant game and many springs in the surrounding forest. It took its name from one of the springs, the Fountain de Bliard, located now in the English Garden, next to the wing of Louis XV. It was used by King Louis VII, for whom Thomas Becket consecrated the chapel in 1169. By Philip Augustus, by Louis IX, or Saint Louis, who built a hospital and a convent, the Couvent des Trinitaires, next to the castle. And by Philippe le Bel, who was born and died in the castle. It is now a national museum and a UNESCO World Heritage Site. From the time of Francis I, the palace was surrounded by formal gardens, representing the major landscaping styles of their periods. The French Renaissance Garden, inspired by the Italian Renaissance Gardens, the French formal garden, the favorite style of Louis XIV. And, in the 18th and 19th century, the French landscape garden, inspired by the English landscape garden. The Garden of Diana was created during the reign of Henry IV. It was the private garden of the king and queen, and was visible from the windows of their rooms. The Fountain of Diana was originally in the center of garden, which at the time was enclosed by another wing, containing offices and later, under Louis XIV, an orangery. The large pond next to the palace, with a surface of 4 hectares, was made during the reign of Henry IV, and was used for boating parties by members of the court, and as a source of fish for the table and for amusement. On the other side of the chateau, one the site of the garden of Francis I, Henry IV created a large formal garden, or parterre along the axis of the parterre. He also built a grand canal 1,200 meters long, similar to one at the nearby Chateau of Fleury-en-Bière.
The Cathedral Basilica of Our Lady of Amiens, or simply Amiens Cathedral, is a Roman Catholic cathedral and seat of the Bishop of Amiens, currently Jean-Luc Bouilleret. It is situated on a slight ridge overlooking the River Somme in Amiens, the administrative capital of the Picardy region of France, some 120 kilometers north of Paris. It is the 19th largest church in the world. Medieval cathedral builders were trying to maximize the internal dimensions in order to reach for the heavens and bring in more light. In that regard, the Amiens Cathedral is the tallest complete cathedral in France, its stone vaulted nave reaching an internal height of 42.30 meters, surpassed only by the incomplete Beauvais Cathedral. It also has the greatest interior volume of any French cathedral, estimated at 200,000 cubic meters. The cathedral was built between 1220 and 1270 and has been listed as a UNESCO World Heritage Site since 1981. Although it has lost most of its original stained glass, Amiens Cathedral is renowned for the quality and quantity of early 13th century Gothic sculpture in the main west facade and the south transept portal, and a large quantity of polychrome sculpture from later periods inside the building. The west front of the cathedral, built in a single campaign from 1220 to 1236, shows an unusual degree of artistic unity. Its lower tier with three vast deep porches is capped with a gallery of 22 over life-size kings, which stretches across the entire facade beneath the rose window. Above the rose window there is an open arcade, the Galerie des Honneurs. Flanking the nave, the two towers were built without close regard to the former design, the south tower being finished in 1366, the north one, reaching higher, in 1406. The western portals of the cathedral are famous for their elaborate sculpture, featuring a gallery of locally important saints and large eschatological scenes. Statues of saints in the portal of the cathedral have been identified as including the locally venerated saints Victoricus and Gentian, Saint Domitius, Saint Elphia, and Saint Firmin. The spire over the central crossing was added between 1529 and 1533. The surface area is 7,700 square meters, the largest in France.
Mary Tapu Tapu Adia is a large Mary complex at Opoa in Tapu Tapu Adia, on the southeastern coast of Riadia. The site features a number of Mary and other stone structures, and was once considered the central temple and religious center of eastern Polynesia. In 2017, the Tapu Tapu Adia area was inscribed on the UNESCO World Heritage Sites list, with Tapu Tapu Adia Mary being described as the heart of the site. The Mary was already established by 1000 AD with significant expansion after this time. The Mary was a place of learning, where priests and navigators from all over the Pacific would gather to offer sacrifices to the gods and share their knowledge of the genealogical origins of the universe and of deep ocean navigation. An alliance known as Tahuayadia was established with the surrounding islands, demarcating those to the west of Riadia, Tiaadia, and those to the east, Tiaauri. This alliance included the Cook Islands, the Australs, Kapu Kapu Akia in Hawaii, and Tapu Tapu Adia in New Zealand. New Mary were established on each of these islands, with a rock being taken from Tapu Tapu Adia, Riadia, to act as a spiritual link. However, the alliance was finally broken when fighting broke out at a gathering, and the two leading high priests representing the alliance were killed. The people of Aoti fled the island, leaving via the reef passage of Tiavarua, rather than the sacred passage of Tiavamaya, which was considered a bad omen. An attempt was made in 1995 to heal this wrongdoing. Around 1763, warriors from Bora Bora attacked the island, defeating Tupaya, and ransacked the island. This included destroying the god houses at Tapu Tapu Atia, wrecking the platform, and cutting down the sheltering trees. James Cook, Joseph Banks, Dr. Daniel Solander and Tupaya arrived aboard the Endeavour on 20 July 1769 to take possession of Raiatea, Tahaat, Huahen, and Bora Bora in the name of King George III of the United Kingdom. This seemed to be the culmination of a prophecy made by the priest Vida that a new people would arrive aboard a canoe without an outrigger and take possession of the islands.
Carcassonne is a fortified French town in the Aude department, of which it is the prefecture, in the region of Occitanie. Carcassonne is located in the south of France, about 80 kilometers east from the city of Toulouse. Its strategic location between the Atlantic Ocean and the Mediterranean Sea has been known since the Neolithic era. Inhabited since the Neolithic period, Carcassonne is located in the Aude plain between historic trade routes, linking the Atlantic to the Mediterranean Sea and the Massif Central to the Pyrenees. Its strategic importance was quickly recognized by the Romans who occupied its hilltop until the demise of the Western Roman Empire and was later taken over in the 5th century by the Visigoths who founded the city. Its strategic location led successive rulers to expand its fortifications until the Treaty of the Pyrenees in 1659. The fortified city itself consists essentially of a concentric design of two outer walls with 53 towers and barbicans to prevent attack by siege engines. The castle itself possesses its own drawbridge and ditch leading to a central keep. The walls consist of towers built over quite a long period. One section is Roman and is notably different from the medieval walls with the telltale red brick layers and the shallow pitch terracotta tile roofs. One of these towers housed the Catholic Inquisition in the 13th century and is still known as the Inquisition Tower. Carcassonne was the first fortress to use hoardings in times of siege. Temporary wooden ramparts would be fitted to the upper walls of the fortress through square holes beneath the rampart itself. It provided protection to defenders on the wall and allowed defenders to go out past the wall to drop projectiles on attackers at the wall beneath. The city is famous for the Site de Carcassonne, a medieval fortress restored by the theorist and architect Eugène Viollet-le-Duc in 1853 and added to the UNESCO list of World Heritage Sites in 1997. Consequently, Carcassonne relies heavily on tourism but also counts manufacture and winemaking as some of its other key economic sectors. The Pont du Gard is an ancient Roman aqueduct that crosses the Garden River near the town of Verspont du Gard in southern France. The Pont du Gard is the highest of all elevated Roman aqueducts, and, along with the Aqueduct of Segovia, one of the best preserved. It was added to UNESCO's list of World Heritage Sites in 1985 because of its historical importance. The aqueduct bridge is part of the Nîmes Aqueduct, a 50-kilometer system built in the 1st century AD to carry water from a spring at Uzes to the Roman colony of Nemausus, Nîmes. Because of the uneven terrain between the two points, the mostly underground aqueduct followed a long, winding route that called for a bridge across the gorge of the Garden River. The bridge has three tiers of arches, stands 48.8 meters high, and descends a mere 2.5 centimeters. While the whole aqueduct descends in height by only 12.6 meters over its entire length, which is indicative of the great precision that Roman engineers were able to achieve, using simple technology. The aqueduct formerly carried an estimated 40,000 cubic meters of water a day to the fountains, baths and homes of the citizens of Nîmes. It may have been in use as late as the 6th century, with some parts used for significantly longer. But a lack of maintenance after the 4th century led to clogging by mineral deposits and debris that eventually choked off the flow of water. After the Roman Empire collapsed and the aqueduct fell into disuse, the Pont du Gard remained largely intact, due to the importance of its secondary function, as a toll bridge. For centuries the local lords and bishops were responsible for its upkeep, in exchange for the right to levy tolls on travelers using it to cross the river. Although some of its stones were looted and serious damage was inflicted on it in the 17th century. It attracted increasing attention starting in the 18th century, and became an important tourist destination. It underwent a series of renovations between the 18th and 21st centuries, commissioned by the local authorities and the French state, that culminated in 2000 with the opening of a new visitor center and the removal of traffic and buildings from the bridge and the area immediately around it. Today it is one of France's most popular tourist attractions, and has attracted the attention of a succession of literary and artistic visitors.
Annecy is the largest city of Haute-Savoie department in the Auvergne-Rhône-Alpes region in southeastern France. It lies on the northern tip of Lake Annecy, 35 kilometers south of Geneva. Nicknamed the Pearl of French Alps in Raoul Blanchard's monograph describing its location between lake and mountains, the city controls the northern entrance to the lake gorge. Due to the lack of available land, its resident population has remained stagnant, with 52,029 inhabitants living within the city limits in 2013. However, its urban area, with 221,000 inhabitants, is on the fifth regional position, just behind the Geneva Annemasse urban area, which counts 292,000 inhabitants in the northern department. Switching from counts of Geneva's dwelling in the 13th century to counts of Savoy's in the 14th century, the city became the capital of the Savoy province in 1434 during the prerogative of Genevois Nemours until 1659. Its role increased in 1536, during the Calvinist Reformation of Geneva, while the bishop took refuge in Annecy. Saint Francis de Sales gave Annecy its role of advanced citadel of the Catholic Counter-Reformation. The annexation of Savoy will link the city to France in 1860. Sometimes called Venice of the Alps, this idyllic and touristic representation comes from its two canals, and the Thiou River lying through the old city, and whose initial role was to protect the city and to empower its handicrafts. The city experienced an industrial development in the 19th century with silk manufacturing. Some of its industrial legacy remains today within the head offices of NTNSNR Bearings, Salomon, Entremont, and Dassault Aviation. Since the end of the 19th century, Annecy has developed as a tourist center with the proximity of the lake, winter resorts and the renovation of its castle, inaugurated with the opening of its Fine Art Museum in 1956. The municipal environmental policy managed to keep 40.3% of green spaces in the city, and was awarded the Golden Flower in 2015, given to the 9 most flowered French cities. Since 1960, Annecy has been the organizer of the Annecy International Animated Film Festival, hosted at the Bonlieu Cultural Center. It has also been a growing educational center since the establishment of the University of Savoy in 1973.
Aquarium de La Rochelle is a family-owned public aquarium in La Rochelle, France. In 1988, during the Second International Aquarium Congress in Monaco, the opening of the Aquarium La Rochelle was announced as being the one of the biggest French aquarium at the time. The aquarium, then located near the Marina of Les Minimes, was over 1,600 square meters with 36 aquaria whose volume total was 550,000 liters. Within 12 years, the building welcomed 7 million visitors. The aquarium moved due to this success, and a new one was inaugurated near the viewport, in the middle of the city of La Rochelle, in 2001. With a surface area of over 8,445 square meters, it is part of the biggest European public aquariums. It exhibits more than 12,000 animals of 600 different species which are split into 3 million liters of seawater, including 1.5 million liters for the sharks area. The aquarium is open every day of the year. The tour requires at least 2 hours of visiting. The tour is made for families since observation points at children's heights are provided, as well as audio guides. To access to the rooms, visitors are invited to take elevators, so that they feel like they are going deep inside the ocean. Atlantic Room, 19 aquariums display local species of Charente Maritime coasts and of the intertidal zone. Mediterranean Room, composed of 12 aquariums, this room displays fishes, invertebrates and corals of Mediterranean Sea. Oceanic Area, a huge aquarium displays fauna living off the coasts of Africa. Jellyfish Area, this room is dedicated to jellyfishes from tropical and temperate waters. Two tube-shaped aquariums allow visitors admire plankton. Caribbean Room, five aquariums are dedicated to species living in the Caribbean. In a huge terrarium, a recreated mangrove can be observed. Indo-Pacific Room, 21 aquariums, including a giant one of 100,000 liters, display different species of fishes, invertebrates and corals living in the Great Barrier Reef and in the Hawaiian and Red Sea archipelagos. Three aquariums plunged into total darkness allow visitors observe life of the nighttime reef, bioluminescence, fluorescence and light absorption. Sharks Area, different species of sharks can be observed from tiers. Amphitheater Aquarium, this aquarium of 150,000 liters displays surgeon fishes and giant trevally fishes evolving among moray eels, a green turtle and a scale turtle which weighs 60 kilograms. Tropical Greenhouse, composed of the aquarium and a turtle river, the greenhouse allows visitors admire varied fauna and flora.